Spielberg had just released and received critical backlash for his weak effort into comedy with the World War II flick 1941. Like Close Encounters and Jaws, it went way over budget and schedule, but unlike those movies, it failed to make as much money back. That was his slap on the wrist, and the young director promised himself that with his next feature, he would make sure that he completed the project on time and in budget. Discussing future projects with Star Wars creator George Lucas, Spielberg explained that he wanted to make a James Bond-style movie, a globe-trotting adventure. Lucas described to him an idea he had already devised of an adventure-seeking archaeologist who fits Spielberg's requirements completely, then known as Indiana Smith, and his search for the Lost Ark of the Covenant, based on the style of the old adventure serials that Lucas had loved as a youngster. Of course, Spielberg leapt at the chance, and the rest become history. What they created was an exciting and thrilling high-concept B-movie, with cliffhangers, laughs and excitement throughout. Romance and betrayal, good and evil, peril and magic that hit the mark with audiences the world over. By now, we all accept Harrison Ford as the face of Indy. The two are synonymous, but it was very nearly Tom Selleck who graced our screens. Luckily for us, his contract for the hit TV show Magnum PI meant that he couldn't commit. Spielberg suggested Harrison Ford and took a little time convincing Lucas, who could only see Han Solo when he thought of the actor. The movie opens well, with its precursors to the adventures ahead as Indy and his devious companion, a young Alfred Molina, make their way through the perilous booby-trapped caves to uncover the golden idol. The first series of shots, our hero is in shadow, silhouette, or with his back to us, always walking away from the camera, his cool swagger and fedora hat being the only giveaway. The opening prologue is another of those iconic scenes of cinema, especially as Indy is chased out of the cave by the gigantic boulder. The pendulum of the film's plot is very quickly set into motion. Once back on his own turf, Indy's friend Marcus arrives with two bureaucrats who send him out on his adventure to locate the Ark before the Nazis, and Belloc, a rival archaeologist. From here on in, there is hardly a dull moment as the movie's fast-paced action and its frequent and hilarious comedy moments continuously bombard us. In fact, this movie has more laughs than any of his films to predate it, especially when Indy is face to face with the swordsman, whose fancy blade work is soon put to a halt by an offhand blast of a pistol. This scene is reported to have been written as an action-packed duel scene, but on the day of filming, Ford, who allegedly had diarrhea and wasn't up to the scene, suggested, "Can't I just shoot him?" which received a laugh and was soon placed into the story. The film's various set pieces and stunt scenes are excellent, and add copious dread and tension to the scenes that these days have lost their edge amongst the overuse of hard-to-believe CGI trickery throughout today's blockbusters. These various scenes really prove that Spielberg had mastered his craft and could make some of the most awesome and exciting scenes on film. The highlights being the fight in Marion's bar as it burns to the ground, and the truck scenes in which an ever-persistent Indy refuses to be thrown free. Karen Allen plays the love interest Marion Ravenwood, a great female counterpart for our hero as she gives as good as she gets, whilst at the same time often portraying a clumsy streak that alternately aids and hinders their journey. Lord of the Rings dwarf Gimli, the giant British actor John Rhys-Davies, plays the part of Indy's ally Sala, a part that was offered to Danny DeVito beforehand. The film's villains are excellently skin-crawling. The venomous tote, Ronald Lacey, a member of the Gestapo, overseeing the uncovering of the Ark, and Indy's slimy French rival Belloc, Paul Freeman, are excellently cast and superbly portrayed. But how does this tremendous picture hold up as a Spielberg movie? What themes and motifs can we identify here in this action-adventure? Well, firstly, its hero is once again the man who has never grown up. His free-spirited sense of adventure and distance and ignorance from the commitment of a relationship with Marion makes him the story's Roy Neary. His down-to-earth alias as a mild-mannered teacher makes him more human too, as well as his irrational fear of snakes. It's also set during the Second World War, the Nazis being the evil forces behind the search for the Ark. A fight scene takes place around an old World War II aircraft and again is shot against the dusty background of the desert, similar to the shots in Close Encounters. Not only is Indiana allegedly named after Lucas's dog, the film is also rife with Star Wars references, the number on Jock's plane, OBCPO, an obvious reference, as well as the Millennium Falcon sound effect as the plane fires into action. A little more subtle would be the hieroglyphics in the Well of Souls, depicting C-3PO and R2-D2. Citizen Kane is also nodded at, as the film's final shot of the Ark packed up in the warehouse is based on a similar shot from Well's masterpiece. Spielberg successfully filmed Raiders in 73 days, and on a budget of $18 million, proved to himself and the studio that he could bring films in time, and with the allotted budget. The movie was nominated for 9 Academy Awards, and took 4 away for sound, editing, visual effects and art set direction. Best director still evading Spielberg. Again, John Williams' score helps to add layers of depth, emotion and excitement to the movie, and another one of those theme tunes that will stand the test of time. Well, that's all I've got time for. Thanks for tuning in. Feel free to leave a comment below, give us a thumbs up, and if you haven't already, don't forget to check out my other videos and subscribe. Good night. We'll be right back.